Hey guys, I'm Dr. Jason Barker with the Natural Athlete Clinic, and I want to talk to you about coffee and cholesterol today. So we know that coffee is a pretty healthy drink, and it's been found to prevent conditions like diabetes, Alzheimer's disease, even pancreatic cancer, and there's a few other conditions out there too that it has a preventive effect on them. However, coffee will raise your cholesterol depending on how it's brewed. So there's a compound in the oils that are produced as part of the brewing process called cafestol. And what cafestol does is it allows your body to produce more cholesterol. So we do have our own internal mechanisms for producing cholesterol. We need it for health. But that cafestol messes with that production and leads to an increase in cholesterol by about 6 to 8% if you're drinking about 2 or more cups of unfiltered coffee every day. So when I say unfiltered, I mean things like French press coffee or espresso. And yes, it goes through a metal filter. However, that metal filter does not capture those oils like a paper filter does. So of course the fix for this is using a paper filter when you brew your coffee. So regular old drip coffee, or if you kind of miss or like that French press flavor, you could do something like a pour over coffee where you'll put the grounds in a little paper filter and pour the hot water over it. Makes a similar cup of coffee. And there's a couple of other different ways of brewing it that way too. But really quickly to summarize, it's just that you just need a paper filter in there and you can watch your cholesterol come down by, again, about 6 to 8%. It's pretty interesting to watch. I have that, I do that in clinic with people who we've seen their cholesterol climb up and they're doing all the right things, and there's no good reason for it. Take a look at how you're brewing your coffee, and that might give you a good answer. So if you find this information helpful or useful, please give us a like. Of course, please subscribe to our channel. Ask questions, and if you know anybody else who's struggling with their cholesterol levels, whether it's just creeping up, like I said, or they've got heart disease, or they've got some other reason they need to be watching their cholesterol, please share this video with them. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you again soon.